Hello, dear friends. Здравствуйте, друзья. Меня зовут Вероника. My name is Вероника, and I congratulate all the world with the victory day, the glorious day when we finally defeated the enemy. In Russian, we say День Победы, the victory day. День means day, Победы means victory. And I am a Russian teacher, and I am a Russian native speaker. I teach Russian to foreigners already for 7 years, and many of my students asked me, Вероника, why not to make this video about Катюша? Most probably you already know that Катюша is a very famous Soviet song that helped soldiers to stay strong. Катюша helped them to defeat the enemy. So yes, I will read the lyrics of Катюша slowly. And if you want to sing this song, it would be very helpful for you. So wait a second, I will show you the lyrics and also English translation of words. English translation is made not by me, but by Игорь Каплевский. So now I start reading slowly. Расцветали яблони и груши, поплыли туманы над рекой, выходила на берег Катюша на высокий берег, на крутой. Выходила, песню заводила про степного сизого орла, про того, которого любила, про того, чьи письма берегла. Ой ты, песня, песенка девичья, ты лети за ясным солнцем вслед, и бойцу на дальнем пограничье от Катюши передай привет. Пусть он вспомнит девушку простую, пусть услышит, как она поет, пусть он землю бережет родную, а любовь Катюша сбережет. Расцветали яблони и груши, поплыли туманы над рекой, выходила на берег Катюша на высокий берег, на крутой. So I hope that you really love this song, because when I read, I feel so strong emotions. I'm kind of a little bit shivering even, because it is so difficult to describe what I feel, but these are very strong emotions, definitely. And now, as usually here on my YouTube channel, I would like to talk a little bit about Russian phonetics. And yeah, let's talk about this. For example, here it is written расцветали, but according to Russian phonetic laws, we read here и расцветали. Why? Because the accent is here on а, and this е in unstressed position we read like и. расцветали яблони. But here is written о, яблони. But we say яблони. Why? Because the accent, the stress is on я. And these о in unstressed position we read like а. Яблони. И груши поплыли. This о is in unstressed position again. That's why we read not поплыли, but поплыли. Туманы над рекой. Wait a second. Поплыли туманы над рекой. The stress is on о. That's why this year, in unstressed position again, we read над рекой. Выходила. О, in unstressed position is а. Выходила на берег. So, normally in everyday Russian speech we say на берег. But this is a song, Катюша. That's why sometimes the stress can be changed. So the stress is here, на берег. That's why this year and this year we read like и, на берег. And this г in the end of the word, according to Russian phonetics, we read like к, на берег. На берег, Катюша, на высокий берег. Yeah, here you see that the stress is where it should be. Берег. And this year we read like и, and this г in the end of the word we read like к. На берег, на крутой. And now let's talk about the next slide. Wait a second. Выходила. This word we already discussed because the stress is on и, and the о is in unstressed position. Выходила. Песню заводила. Again, о in unstressed position. That's why we read not заводила, but заводила. Про степного. This is a very interesting Russian combination that is quite frequently in this song Катюша. Степного. If you see this combination in the end of the word, normally it is written ого, but we read it like ова. Степного. Сизова. The same. Сизова. Орла. Про того. You see, this г we read like в. Про того, которого любила. Про того, чьи письма берегла. So the stress is on I, and this double E again we read like E. Берегла. I hope that these marks are useful for you. And let's see the third slide. Wait a second. Ой, ты песня, песенка. Е in unstressed position, that's why we read песенка. The same девичья. Девичья. Ты лети за ясным солнцем. Russian language is a very consonant system. I mean that we have not a lot of vowels, but many, many different consonant letters. That's why when we have three or more consonants together in one word, some of them we do not pronounce. That's why this L is disappearing from here. Солнцем, вслед. Such a short word, вслед, but it's very interesting if we talk about Russian pronunciation, because this S sound, we pronounce it without voice. That's why this V should be pronounced also without voice. Вслед. Not вслед, but вслед. And this D in the end of the word should be pronounced like T, because in the end of the word D is changing to T, вслед. И бойцу, or in unstressed position is R, as you already know, бойцу на дальнем пограничье. Пограничье. От Катюши передай. Передай. Привет. And let's talk about the next page. Пусть он вспомнит девушку простую. Пусть услышит, как она. Many, many foreigners who learn Russian make a mistake here. They pronounce она how it is written. Она. That's wrong. You should say она поет. Here is tricky Russian letter. I call it forgotten letter already, or disappearing letter. Your with two dots. And this is a very interesting letter because we do not write it in newspapers or in books, only in textbooks for kids and for foreigners we write it. And even in a keyboard, you cannot find easily this letter. So yeah, I think that your with two dots will disappear. And another interesting thing that is, this letter is always under the stress. So the stress is on this your, and this or we read like are, because this in unstressed position поёт. Пусть он землю бережёт. Here again, you with two dots, бережёт. That's why this year and this year we read like и. Бережёт родную, or unstressed is R, а любовь. This is quite famous Russian word. Любовь means love, but if you read it like it is written, любовь, it's a mistake, pronunciation mistake in Russian, because all Russian people say любовь. Why? Because this V in the end of the word is read like F. Любовь. Катюша сбережет. Again, here one more interesting thing, because we have this V and we pronounce V with a voice. B, B, B. That's why this S that we pronounce without voice should be transformed to z, yeah? So you cannot say сбережёт. Well, maybe you can say, but better to say сбережёт, сбережёт. So I hope that this Russian lesson was really interesting for you. If you found some interesting information here at this Russian lesson or at my YouTube channel, please subscribe to my channel and hit the like button. And I'm happy to make new interesting videos for you. And of course, you can donate me if you want, because I'm totally happy with what I'm doing. I love to teach, but I want to buy a new technical equipment for making better videos. And your donations could be very helpful for me. I appreciate it. Спасибо за просмотр. Thank you for watching. Увидимся скоро. See you soon. Пока-пока. And again, I congratulate you with the victory day. Поздравляю вас с Днем Великой Победы. Пока-пока. Bye-bye.